Is there a kind of large enough for the mining mid by any chance?
Because this was a kind of a magic place in the 60s when all the hippies would gather here and come together and have a good time, like 20 years ago.
Yeah, well, it's a much different world these days, isn't it?
You think so?
Oh, it's completely.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
In what way?
Well, go ahead, Lee, you got the spiel. No, go ahead, you got
yeah,
the spiel.
Well, in many different ways. I mean, for one thing, in the 60s, when all the hippies were gathering together for one reason and for one motive, which was, you know, because of the war, and because they all had a reason to come together. And I don't think today that people can really come together like that, because everyone is much too scattered and separated, because people just aren't together now. No one is united for any particular reason. I think it's possible people could be united if they all got together for some common cause, like an environmental concern or something like that, but it doesn't really seem like people can do that. They're all too busy smoking crack and killing each other.
That's how it is in the States.
That's yeah, how it is.
Well, not to mention the state of music today is so completely different than the state of music was then,
yeah,
and that was sort of the uniting factor, you know, in the 60s, and it's just so completely different now. It seems that pop music is made solely for the sake of money, and it's really much more of a product than a feeling. You know, before, the whole purpose of making music was to convey emotions and statements and beliefs and wisdoms and questions, and today, you know what, you got people like Milli Vanilli and Richard Marx that really have absolutely zero substance, and it's tough for a group of people to get behind such an empty state of music, really.
In de zomer van 1988 overleed Hillel Slovak. Tot dat moment gitarist bij de Red Hot Chili Peppers. De doodsoorzaak: een overdosis heroïne.
I used to take those kinds of drugs, and I almost died, and my best friend did die from it. So obviously, I'm very anti-heroin, anti-cocaine, and anti-narcotics in general.
You just mentioned Hillel. Did his death really change your outlook on life?
Well, of course, like any tragic experience, it's going to make a huge change in the way I live the rest of my life. And, you know, I loved him so much, and I'll always miss him so much, and he'll forever live on as part of me and part of the music that we make, because he was just instrumental in the whole creation of the Red Hot Chili Peppers, as well as the creation of my life. And that's really all I have to say about that.
You want to add anything to that?
I mean, the only thing I could say is that I miss him very much, and I love him very much. And like Anthony said, he'll always be an energy in a band. though he might not be an earthly presence anymore, his influence and energy will always live in the Red Hot Chili Peppers. It's more than just someone from the band dying. It's a friend that's gone. It means much more than any one band or any, you know, piece of music or anything like that.
In a twisted irony of fate, he died in part so that perhaps I could go on living, you know, because I learned such an invaluable lesson from his dying that, you know, I didn't have to die, you know.
Do it, Jeff.